What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigos Code. In this video, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about the DTO pattern, a question that a lot of you guys have been asking me. So I decided to record a video so that you understand exactly what it is and how to take advantage so that you don't expose information to the client, which shouldn't be exposed. So this video right here is actually part of the brand new course, which I'm about to release in about 2 weeks or so. And this is the full stack course where I'm going to show you how to build an entire application from start to finish using all of the latest technologies such as Docker, AWS, React, Angular as well. Yes, I know. And we're going to add security on top of our application, including CI/CD with GitHub Actions and Slack integration and the whole shebang, really. So this course is about 30 hours long. I know, 30 hours long. It's massive, and it's a course that will take you from beginner to professional. So I'm super excited, and make sure to subscribe so that you are the first one to be notified. Also, I've got a giveaway currently, and I'm giving out IntelliJ licenses, or in fact, the whole suite of IDEs licenses that you can obtain so that you can use IntelliJ Ultimate, Goland, WebStorm, DataGrip, and the whole shebang. All you have to do is 1, smash the like button, 2, comment down below, 3, make sure to follow me on my LinkedIn profile, which I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video, and number 4, join the Discord community. And within the Discord server, there is a special chat where you can enter the giveaway. So you can find the instructions for the giveaway in the description of this video. Without further ado, let's kick off this video. Cool. So DTO stands for Data Transfer Object. And the idea is that in your database, you might have models such as customer, which has name, password, also a car, which has brand, price, and a bunch of other fields in here. So here I'm actually limiting the fields for illustration purposes. And these entities right here, they are stored in a database. Now, the idea of the DTO pattern is that you have a mapper in here. So this mapper is responsible for performing data transformation from one data type to another. Now here, the data type, so basically if you want to send, for example, the customer information to your client that consumes the API, it's not really feasible for you to send the password, right? So you would never do that. And if you do, trust me, you're gonna be in trouble, right? So what you do is you have the mapper, and this mapper will basically take maybe the customer as well as the car, and it will perform a transformation, meaning that it will take the information or the properties and then transform it into a data type, or in this case, a class called customer DTO, where here you have full control of what fields you expose to your API. So the client, when it sends an HTTP request, for example, it's not aware of the internals of your system. All it gets is whatever you have exposed. Hence, data transfer object. Now, the beauty of this is that you can build different views from your domain models. So in here, so if you have a bunch of other classes in here that you basically want to send to your client, so one HTTP request, then another one for getting the car, then another one for getting transactions, another one for getting the address. So you can see 4 HTTP requests. What you do instead is you basically bundle everything into one request, and the customer or the DTO model takes care of that. So basically, you can build different views of your domain models as well as reduce the number of calls. So I want to actually give you an example. So let's have a look at this API in here, and we're going to fix it. So this actually is part of my brand new course, which is about to come out. And this is a full stack application where I'm going to teach you pretty much everything you need to know in order to build a full stack application with security. So here I do have a token for a customer. And if I send the HTTP request for getting all customers, you can see that here I'm getting, you know, a bunch of information. And if you look carefully in here, so have a look, password. Now, obviously, this password doesn't mean too much because it's hashed, but we don't want to expose this to the client. And also, maybe you don't want to expose whether the credentials have expired or the account is locked, so on and so forth. But surely, we don't want to expose the password to the client. So what we're going to do is to use the DTO pattern. Now, for DTO pattern, there's many libraries such as the MapStruct. And in here, I'm within the official page for MapStruct. And it says Java Beans Mapping Made Easy. They explain what it is, why, and how. And if you click on Get Started, so in here, they give you basically an example where you've got the car class and you want to map it into a different class. So car DTO in here. And you've got the mapper itself in here. And basically, this is just an interface where you basically get the mapper itself, you tell it which class, and off you go. Now, I'm not going to teach you MapStruct because I feel like it's better for you to understand exactly without using a library on top. But if you want me to teach you MapStruct, feel free to let me know. Cool. Now, let me give you an example with some code. So in here, I've got the repo, which is for the Spring Boot full stack course, which is about 30 hours long. And I'm going to leave a link where you can go and clone the repo. But essentially, if you look into our customer controller in here, check this out. So here we have customer and customer. So list of customer and then customer. Now, this customer right here is basically a class that implements user details. And this is an entity, right? So this is a JPA entity. Have a look at and an entity. Now, this is bad for us because we don't want to expose. And you can see that this class actually is filled with annotations, right? So what we want to do is to have a simple structure that we will basically define and have full control of what fields the client should have access to and not the entire thing. Now here, obviously, have a look. We've got the password. So the client is getting the password, which we don't want, and some other fields. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new class. Right. So now here we need a new class, and this will be called customer and then DTO for data transfer object. Now, this class in here, you could say private, final, string, blah, 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 blah. But instead, let's change this to a record. So the DTO should be as simple as possible without no logic. So I'm going to change this to a record. And inside here, we want to have basically all the fields that we want to expose to the client. So in our case, we've got the ID, we've got the name, we've got the email, the password. We want to omit that from the client. So let's just have all the fields in here that we want to present to our client. So in here, let me just paste the fields that I want. So ID, name, email, gender, age, roles, as well as the username. And if you look carefully, so our customer class, it has way more. So here we've got, for example, the fact that the account is non-expired, where it's non-locked, the credential, whether it's enabled and whatnot. So at this point in time, I don't need the client to know this information. So I'm going to hide that. Also, the password. So here, let's just go back to our DTO. And it's as simple as this. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to change the controller in here to, instead of returning the customer itself, we're going to return the DTO. So customer DTO, and also in here, customer DTO. Now, obviously, this is now failing the contract. So let's just go and fix the get all customers within customer service. So here, this will be DTO, and the same for this guy in here. So this will be DTO. Now, the way that this is going to work is we're going to say that we want to stream and say dot and then map. We want to map from one data type to the other. So what we get from this select all customers is a customer object. So we want to map the customer into the DTO itself. So here, let's just say new and then customer DTO. So customer DTO, and inside we can say customer.getID. Then we need, I think it's the, so have a look. So here the name, so customer.getName. we need the email, so customer.getEmail, the gender, customer, dot, and then get, and then gender. We also need to basically have the age, customer.getAge, and also the roles. So the roles here, it's a list of granted authorities. So customer.get and then authorities dot, and then we're going to basically map. So we want to map this. Let's just put it on a new line. So just like this. So we're going to map, and here we have the role itself, and we want to say r dot and then get authority as a string. And here we want to say dot and then collect to list. Cool. Then we also have to have the username. So here this will be customer dot and then get username. And finally dot and then collect to list and put this on a new line. So you see that here we can also use method reference and we're good to go. Nice. So you can see that here, basically this is the mapper function. So what we're going to do actually is we're going to extract this in here. So let's go back, and here I'm going to say new Java class and then customer and then DTO and then mapper. So here what we're going to do is we're going to say implement a function, and this function will basically receive the customer and return the customer DTO. So if you're not sure about functional programming, go and check my course on functional programming and Java streams where I teach all of this. So here, let's just say service. And in this mapper in here, all I want to do is to basically take the code that we have in here. So basically all of this, go back, and then we're going to return that. So return new customer, and this should just work. And I miss the parentheses, and we're good to go. If I indent everything, cool. So now what we can do is we can inject it. So private, final, and then here we're going to say customer and then DTO row mapper. And this guy, so let's just change the order, put it within the constructor. We're going to fix the tests in a second. So I want to make sure that this works indeed. And now here, instead of having all of this, we could just say customer DTO role mapper, job done. You can see that this is much beautiful. So here we could also reuse the code. So let's just basically say dot and then map and then customer DTO and then mapper. Now we have one issue here, and that is that this method, so depends on this code without the mapper. So that's fine. So let's just basically paste the code here. And we could refactor this. So just pass the customer ID there, here as well, and remove the mapper. And this right here is the customer. So customer. And we'll run the tests to make sure that everything works, right? And you can see that this is much beautiful, right? Now let me get rid of this in here and let's fix the test itself. So let's just go to the customer service test. And here we have to pass the role mapper. So let's just say private and then final. And this will be customer DTO and then mapper. And this is basically the mapper equals to new. And then basically here, we don't need to mock this because this is just dumb implementation. So here I'm going to pass it inside. And this guy right now, so here we have the can get customer, and basically it says when we get the customer, so this should be the customer DTO, and the assertion now is that we expect, so let's just say customer DTO, and then here I'm going to say expected equals to customer and then DTO mapper dot apply, we get the customer, and this should be our expectation. So here, actual is what we get is equal to the expected. Cool. So this is pretty much it. And I think we don't have to fix anything else. Let's just run all the tests. Fingers crossed, everything should just work. Hooray, you can see that beautiful stuff. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to start the application, or actually restart the application. I think it's running. Yes, it's running. And let's see that everything should just work. So you can see that now we have a new customer which was inserted. And if I open a Postman, and remember before within the body, so within the body, we actually, I think I lost the body. But before we had the password in there, which we didn't need the password at all. So here, let's just send the request and I have to pass the authorization, bearer token and paste it. And right now I'm going to send and check this out. So this is beautiful stuff. So here now we have full control of what the client sees. And it doesn't see like the overall backend and all of those models that we have. And here I have full control, which is beautiful. And this is the DTO pattern in action. It's as easy as this. Now here, if you want to combine multiple objects into your DTO, you can do so. So here, if I go back and if I close this and within our customer DTO, so here, this, instead of being this, it could have been a customer, for example. So maybe you have a record and this could be the customer and then call it like customer and then DTO. And then maybe you have the address, you could call it address and then DTO. And here you could just say, for example, the response, right? And this is pretty much it. In fact, let me just show you that we've been using, so here, if I go to the controller itself, in here, we've been using DTOs, but I didn't say DTO in the class name, but they are DTOs, so data transfer object. So this is from this method where we register a customer. Have a look, customer registration request. So data transfer object from the client to the server. And this is both ways. So if you look at the customer registration request, this is a record and the client doesn't send the ID in here because the ID is auto-generated and all of the other fields such as the authorities and roles and whether the account is active or not, because that's basically server information, right? And if you look where we use this customer registration request is within the add customer. And in here, have a look. This is the DTO. And then we map it to a customer like so. Nice and easy. And this is pretty much DTO in action. Now, this will basically make our lives easier for our integration. So here where we have our integration tests under journey, customer IT, and that's what we're going to tackle next. Okie dokie, I'm super excited that you've managed to make this far. If you enjoyed this video, literally just take 1 second and smash the like button. Also, don't forget to enter the giveaway so that you can gain the license for the JetBrains IDEs, which they are so, so awesome. And as a software engineer, I think those are the IDEs that you should have. And having the Ultimate, for example, Ultimate Edition for IntelliJ is just a game changer. So make sure to enter the giveaway. And stay tuned for the brand new course, which I will release very soon. This is pretty much it. I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum.